Bebe. How many good things are happening today?
Oh, tons. We are moving out. We are going on Koru, and it's our anniversary.
And what else?
It's Valentine's Day.
How cheesy is that?
The weeks leading up to this day have been a true roller coaster of feelings. This is 9 days before we leave, and we are ready to get this party started. Today is moving day.
Sold our bed, sleeping on a mattress, which is kind of cool. Reminds me of my, high school years. No more TV, furniture.
Most of our belongings are packed up, and we moved to a little apartment next door for the last couple of days in Switzerland. We have been taking on some extremely long flights in our travel careers, but we have never been more nervous about this 1.5 hour flight that we're about to take. Why? Because it will change our lives. We are saying goodbye to a wonderful place and a lot of wonderful people, which we will keep dearly in our hearts. On the day of days, we said our goodbyes to our friends and family, and my cousin Philip took us to the airport to send us off to Barcelona. And that meant only one thing for us. No more waiting. A bit later on, my buddy Jurek also joined us at the airport to crack open a couple of beers and leave us with some of his famous advice.
Jurek, was gibst du uns mit auf den Weg? Irgendeine Weisheit, irgendetwas mega
geschmacken. Ich mache nichts, was ich auch nicht machen
würde. What? That's actually very, very bad advice.
Wasser?
Du gibst uns auf den Weg mit, für einen guten Rat, als alter Seebär.
Wasser
und immer noch. Und ich habe gerade Wasser unter dem Kiel.
Yay!
We made it through.
Babies are gonna fill up pretty quick.
Made it to the bus.
Vale, de acuerdo.
So apparently we rented a car and you can't pick it up at the terminal, so now we just jumped in the bus with all of our stuff. So much. And now we're driving to their office. Go get the car. And after that, we're going to stop in a ferreteria in Tarragona, yes, right, to just get some stuff that we need for Koru tonight already, in order to have power and stuff like that.
Okay, here we are at the car rental place. Food just went inside to get our car. We probably need a bigger one that we rented because of all the luggage, but we'll see. The okay rental place. We had to get a bigger car, but it's okay, right?
Yeah, it is. It's great.
And it was a bargain. How much was it?
The upgrade was 40 Swiss francs, about 33 euros.
For how many days? For a week.
Including 300 kilometers per day.
Oh, really? Seriously? Nice. Nice
so,
one.
We're good to go.
Good.
It's extremely, it's new.
It is pretty new,
it's
huh?
It's 10 kilometers.
Are you serious?
Yeah, it says 10 kilometers.
So I hope that everything is legit here.
And everything was legit. For only 33 euros, we rented a car for a whole week, including over 2,000 kilometers. Okay, rental car seems okay. We quickly stopped at the hardware store to pick up some stuff we needed to get Koru up and running. To be honest, I was really excited about the upcoming boat work.
Well, we have decided to do whatever we can ourselves. That means sanding, painting, primer, anti-fouling, the anodes, oil seals, like everything, or whatever we can. So we're gonna start on Monday. Really looking forward to do some boat work. Check this out. What a mess. What a mess. Oh man. But good thing is we only do it once, because once is enough, right?
But hey, on the other hand, it's very liberating to give away things you don't really need and make space for new things like tools, spare parts, paint, sanding paper, and all the other wonderful boat stuff. I always consider myself as a pretty handy one, but when it comes to boat work, I'm as much as a virgin as anyone else who never had anything to do with boats. In the beginning, I was very anxious and didn't think that we could do everything ourselves, but after a few first chores, we were confident enough to take on everything on our list. Of course, Uncle YouTube and Aunt Google have played their part. Since we had a couple of windless days ahead of us, we decided to start with rigging the sails, and it went surprisingly well for two newbies. After inspecting all the lines, we have decided to order a new main halyard and a new main sheet. The old ones were still usable, but we wanted to be ready in case one of them bites the dust. Was a bit banged up when we arrived. It slowly loses air, so we took it off the foredeck and tried to find out more about its condition. We couldn't find anything on land, so we thought we'd take it for a spin and see if she sinks. Very clever, guys. Very clever.
There she is. She's losing air. It's not cool. And she's slowly filling with water too. It's a mess. So yeah, we're going to try to find the leak. Come here. Put. Oh, we got it on camera. I don't know what we got on camera, but we got something. Nice.
But you have to... This is
around where they don't charge more for a catamaran instead of monohull.
True, huh?
I think so.
Yeah.
It would make sense. I mean, why pay more if you don't have to?
So if you own a catamaran and you're in the Western Mediterranean, come to St. Carl's at Arabica. Yep. St. Carl's Marina. Whoop whoop.
After Ria got us back to shore safely, we got some well-deserved shut-eye to take on the next day.
Then the right one?
Do you know what you're doing?
I have no idea.
Okay, it wasn't that bad. After fixing some other minor issues with the plumbing system and some safety related things, I made myself familiar with Sikaflex, the duct tape of the boating world. We finally got our backing plates for the bowsprit stays and started with the install of these babies right away. And just like that, Koru is ready to splash. Only one thing left to do.
That looks beautiful. GoPro.
I have the washer.
Stop recording.
No, these.
GoPro, stop recording. GoPro, stop recording.
What's the deal, babe?
We're gonna hoist our flag. Since we have a boat now, we converted. We are now Dutch.
We hoisted our colors. Well, the colors of convenience. We're Swiss, sailing in Spain under Dutch flag. Welcome to Europe, people.
Want to do the Spanish flag as well?
Absolutely.
That's boogie.
There are a few things you have to consider when raising a flag on a boat. Size, ratio, port or starboard, how high up, all of which we had no idea.
Don't have to break down the flag again, because we're looking out and we always have to be on starboard deck. I mean...
Your national flag should be displayed at the stern of the vessel or somewhere along the main leech. The courtesy flag is flown off your starboard side right beneath the first spreader of the most forward mast. If you are of different nationality than the flag you're flying, you can also display your own flag right beneath the courtesy flag. Thanks for watching, guys. Join us in the next episode when we take a well-deserved break and head north to see a little bit more of Barcelona and a cathedral that is in the build for over a century. We're taking an epic hike and finally put Koru in the water.